Good day, fellow investors. I hope you enjoyed my Eldorado video, where it was clear that Eldorado was a bargain. And now I want to discuss Pretium Resources, another stock that looks like a bargain. Let's dig deeper into the mine. The main mine of Pretium Resources, the only mine, is the Brucejack gold mine that has started commercial production in July 2017. And this is the main issue around Pretium. Will the pre-feasibility study, the technical updates, be confirmed or not? What Pretium wants to mine is the Valley of Kings and the West Zone at Brucejack, and you can see here that the gold grades are extremely high. Proven reserves 14.5, probable 16.5 for the Valley of Kings per ton, grams per ton, West Zone 7.2, 6.5. In total, the contained ounces of gold are 8.7 million ounces. Multiply that with 1,300 and what is the price of gold, and you get to more than $9 billion, which is huge. The mine life, 18 years according to plan. They will mine 7.27 million ounces, 500,000 ounces of gold per year, very high gold and silver recovery. So if they hit that, then Pretium is very, very cheap. From the technical report, the current net present value of the mine at a 5% discount rate, say it is around 2 billion. Pretium market cap is 1.5 billion, so there is still the 25% difference in order to get to the net present value. However, the difference now is that the capital has been spent. The 811 million needed to develop the mine have been spent. So what's left is just pure cash flows. So the capex is closed, gold sales are already underway. Their goal is to pay down their debt of 600 million. If they produce 500,000 ounces of gold, they could easily pay down the debt in 2017 and 2018. And they also have a stream to buy back. Just a quick look at the balance sheet. You can see the long-term debt, 616 million, they want to pay it back. After that, you can expect high dividends if the plan goes as planned. What's very important with Pretium is that we are here. So we are just about to start going into net cash flows. When you look at a technical study, you get the net present value that includes the money that has been spent. That's the 800 million. Okay, there is 600 million of debt, but everything has been developed. The development stage has a lot of risks, so that is behind us. And now all that Pretium has to do is take 2 years of cash flows, two and a half years of cash flows to pay back the debt. And then you have a company that will have cash flows of around $300 million for almost 9 years after that. So we can expect Pretium to have cash flows of around $300 million per share for the next 9 plus 3 12 years, till 2029 at least. With 180 million shares outstanding, you can easily see why the company is very undervalued, because cash flows of $1 $1.5 per year would really, really have a positive impact on the stock. And then if you pay $8 for cash flows of 9 years of $1.5, then it's cheap. And this cash flow calculation from the feasibility study was made at gold prices of 1,100 per ounce. Now gold prices are a bit higher, almost 20% higher. So we can add 20 or even more percent to these net cash flows. It's even interesting that Pretium has 10 million convertible shares with the dilution price at 16. That's double what it is now. What's also very interesting is that Pretium has a huge reserve expansion target. This is the Valley of Kings, this is the West Zone, and they have made drills that show, I don't know, 2 meters of gold at 2,100 grams per ton, which is amazing and huge. So if they can develop this, they learn how to mine the resource in the West Zone in the Valley of Kings, and then bring the same technology towards the new findings, you can expect many, many more years of mining and high production from the Brucejack mine. Now, the main risks surrounding Pretium are the grades. There has been plenty of discussion and even some class action suits against Pretium that the grades included in the Brucejack study are not correct. And if we look what they produced from their management discussion, the grades coming out of the Brucejack mine are not the 15 gram per ton expected. They are 3.4 and 5.74 July. So everything on what will happen at Pretium depends on the upcoming grades. Those grades should have been 15, almost 15 grams per ton. The reason behind the low grades, according to management, is the development muck and the low grade stockpiles. Let's hope that that really is the case and not a different resource than in the technical report. Because if you go back to the old technical reports, 2011, before the last one that was adjusted, you see that the Brucejack estimated mineral resources have a gold grade of 2.25 grams per ton. So if we compare again the current estimated mineral resource and the 2011 estimated mineral resource, one could simply ask, okay, they just eliminated the lower grade ore and they said we will mine only the higher grade ore. However, that's pretty complicated to do. And what you can do in the future is really trade Pretium when they manage to hit the 15 grams per ton or even higher, then you sell it. When they don't manage to do that and they hit lower grades like they have been doing now, then you buy it. So I really expect Pretium to be a volatile stock according to mining grades. Therefore, also very risky, because if they don't hit the 15 grams per ton, the net present value quickly goes below the current value of the company. And that's the main risk of Pretium, and everybody should be aware of it. So I look at different gold miners. We have already done Eldorado, we have made a video of Harmony Gold, there will be plenty more in order to find the best low-risk, high-reward investments. It's not that easy, and Pretium, I must say, I don't know the geology of the resource, I don't know what will they find out, perhaps with time that will come out, but for me now the risk is too much. If they don't hit the 15 grams per ton, they hit 10, they hit 7, then there is really potential for permanent capital loss, and that's something I don't like. I love low-risk, high reward investments, and at this point Pretium is not. I'm sorry to disappoint the Pretium long ones, but okay, that's my opinion. It's always nice also to hear an opposite opinion, and I hope you enjoyed the presentation and I added value. I'm looking forward to your comments and where am I wrong in the risk reward assessment, and to really facts that can help really paint a better picture for those interested in Pretium. Thank you for watching, consider subscribing if you haven't yet, click like if you like the content, click like if you dislike the content, and I'll see you in the next video.